Rastafari is a sacred way of life. Your heart have to be clean and pure.
I love Rastafari. I love to do the things that is right before God.
Rastafari is love, it's light, it's respect, it's righteousness, it's overstanding that yes, we do have examples, living examples of a black king and a black queen.
Rastafari is a movement inspired by the teachings of His Imperial Majesty Emperor Haile Selassie of Ethiopia.
From the time 1892 when he was born, that is what has guided me personally and have helped me to have my children and my family on a pathway that I see that is a righteous pathway.
In the 1920s, the Jamaican-born black nationalist leader Marcus Garvey foretold of the day when a black king would rise to power in Africa.
Marcus Garvey is very important because black people in the time of Marcus Garvey was living in a stagnant state where we didn't have any freedom of will, and he put himself out to show us the way.
So Marcus Garvey had come and said, look to the east for the crowning of our king, who shall be an I redeemer and I savior.
Many Rastafari interpret this prediction as a divine prophecy fulfilled when Emperor Selassie was crowned Emperor of Ethiopia in 1930.
When we see that reality manifest, that there was a king and this king was crowned, and when we see the beauty of the crowning and the beauty of the king, it inspired the people.
And yes, as Christus, who was crowned the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, he was ready to receive riches and blessings, as the people see the historical event. The priests were there, everyone, all the nations were gathered, celebrating and commemorating the coronation of the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the conquering land of the tribe of Judah.
So it was people from all over the world. People came from Jamaica. As we know, there was a representative from Jamaica, who is Percival Owen, who came back to Jamaica with the crowning.
As the first person to preach the divinity of Emperor Haile Selassie, Leonard Percival Howell spread the news and images of the coronation back to Jamaica.
Powell,
yes,
is the first man. Come here and make the people notice. Aye. And I buy a photo for 1 shilling with the one going for the man, Selassie. Aye.
When Italian forces invaded Ethiopia in 1935, Emperor Selassie emerged as an African freedom fighter.
After all what the Italians did, Haile Selassie ultimately showed. That's why we know him as a Christ, you know.
We praise him for his wonderful performance, fighting a war against Mussolini and war. Not by the hand of men, but by the powers and powers of the Almighty.
Mussolini going to Ethiopia to overthrow his majesty. He overthrew himself.
Ethiopia's emperor, Haile Selassie, appeared before the League of Nations.
When he went to Geneva, he's warning them. He said that, you know, he said, we have a covenant. Force come upon you, and you're bowing to this force. I'm going to force God and history shall record his judgment, because you should stand up to it.
Haile Selassie come and show the ultimate heights. He forgave them.
Inspired by the teachings of the emperor and the fulfillment of divine prophecy, many Rastafari today continue to praise the divinity of His Imperial Majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie.
All his people, as he says, until the color of a man's skin be of no more significance, or the color of his eyes, meaning we are all one.
We must become bigger than we have ever been, more courageous in spirit, larger in outlook. We must become members of a new race.
The Almighty Haile Selassie, what did he say unto you? We here in Ethiopia have one of the holiest version of the Bible.
Love is the first commandment in the book. If I love you, I couldn't steal from you. I couldn't tell lie by you.
Now the Bible shows us the way to this faith. It helps us along the way as a guide.
Brother Gad said, a chapter a day from Genesis to Revelations.
Revelation says his name shall be called the Word of God. But Haile Selassie means power of the Trinity. Well, anytime we think about the Trinity, we think about God.
The Bible is a history book, and it is a guidance. For there is no man can go and seek salvation without the Bible.
You can't praise a God where you can't see. You can't hear and you can't feel.
We feel that him subject somewhere, sitting on some throne somewhere. But he's in everyone's heart. He's in nature, he's in power.
The wind will blow his jaw, the sun his jaw. Every living thing that walked upon the face of the earth is still jaw. It is him in all of them.
In the beginning of the movement, Rastafari were routinely persecuted by the Jamaican colonial government for their beliefs and practices.
It was an unspoken word. It was a word that, you know, if you mentioned that you were Rasta, it was a word to be ashamed of.
It was terrible. You couldn't get a ride on public vehicle because you're undesirable.
Anyone looking like Rasta to get employment in the public sector, in the government, I mean, anywhere, there was just so much discrimination.
In those earlier days when we say Grow Nation, we have to take up them drums, you know, and the hymn book of the Bible, and run. If we don't run, the drums going cut up by the police with some big knives, the Bible going fling with the table mash up, and the Rastas them going get some beaten and go to jail and charge something that we didn't charge for.
In my younger days, you were told that the Rasta man is a black heart man, a man that will cut out your heart. Well, in some sense, Rasta really don't cut out your heart, it takes your heart and put it in the right perspective.
While Rastafari faced scorn and oppression within Jamaica, Emperor Haile Selassie surprised the authorities when he embraced the Rastafari brothers and sisters on his first and only visit to Jamaica.
In 1966, the king visited Jamaica.
When the plane touched down, all rain stopped and all hooded wet, dry again. It was one of the happiest days in our life.
His Majesty took a time to come out the plane. And after him come out now and just step now, you know, him give a smile.
When His Majesty came here in 1966, we had seen that part of the scripture had been fulfilled.
The first thing he told me, God knows, he said the black people in Jamaica and the people in Ethiopia are blood brother. Nothing can divide blood.
Beginning in Jamaica, the Rastafari movement soon spread to other countries after the visit of His Majesty.
Rastafari is a universal seed that took root firstly in Jamaica and is now branching to all corners of the world.
You see it going from Jamaica to all the other islands, Trinidad, Antigua, Cuba.
Even before we had the international communication, it was moving out. And now that the world is so connected, it's even stronger because you can reach a bridge in anywhere, you know.
Now when you go to many countries throughout the world, you see that Rastafari takes the shape and the face of many ones and souls.
Every day I see this thing increase more and more. Everywhere I go, I see a new face taking up this mantle and traveling with it.
Through reggae music and the voices of well-traveled elders, the message of Rastafari has truly become an international movement.
Today we see Rasta being more accepted, you know, Bob Marley through reggae music took Rasta to the world, so the whole world now knows Jamaica.
There's a natural mystic blowing through the air.
Reggae music got big because they promote the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. It was the only music that tell of the Jesus Christ in the second coming.
Is Naya Bingi chant and psalms start reggae. But reggae music is a message concerning the King of Kings.
And what one Rastaman tell you here, if you go all over Jamaica, all in the woods, it's the same thing the other one telling you. There's one voice.
All nations have sprung out of Africa, for Africa known as the womb carrier creation. Our God really created the world equal.
For Rastafari, Africa is their sacred homeland. Repatriation to Africa, a central goal of the movement, is based on ideas and sentiments generated by the displacement of Africans during slavery.
We are the sons and daughters of those Africans who were taken from Africa.
After the type of slavery that were going on in Jamaica, shackle slavery, they give us emancipation. That is not total freedom. For 1966, His Majesty had come round here and claims us. That's why I and I does not accept the nationality as a Jamaican.
This is a story that has been talked about from creation, from the first time when we were taken from Africa. We vowed that we must come back. Repatriation distinctively referred to return to a place where you were coming from.
All nations should return under their own vine and fig tree. Everyone have a homeland.
Now is the time that I and I must have one determination, one will.
Repatriation.
Repatriation.
No.
Since the late 1950s, Rastafari brothers and sisters have been repatriating to Shashamani, Ethiopia, where Emperor Selassie set up a land grant of 500 acres for black people from the West.
This is the message. I am given 500 acres of my own land for 500 families of the West. And when it is fulfilled, I am going to put it in for more land to be granted.
Over 70 Rastas are here in just this part of the land grant. You know, this is a real Rasta community in the sense that we live together, we work together, we pray together, you know? Yeah.
His Imperial Majesty have given the land grant to the black people of the diaspora to come home.
There are many different orientations within Rastafari, often referred to as mansions or houses.
In the houses, which is mansions, because in my house there are many mansions. School of Vision is one of them. You have the Naya Bingi Ada in different concepts. You have Naya Bingi Scotch Park. You have Bobo Shanti out in Bull Bay. You have the 12 Tribes. You have Judah Kapti. You have many.
The foundation of Naya Bingi is Rastafari. If you go to 12 Tribes, again, the organization may do things in a different way. The greetings may be a little different. But again, the foundation and the head is Rastafari. And same for the Bobo Shanti.
The foundation of our Congress is really, you know, to keep the Sabbath day holy. This principle is represented by the Trinity. So all our development here is for freedom, redemption, international repatriation.
Irrespective of our difference in how we sight majesty or how we reach to the consciousness, we're all in one boat. If one man get up and rock the boat, everybody is in jeopardy.
The oldest mansion in Rastafari is the House of Naya Bingi. The Naya Bingi established many traditions which have been incorporated into other mansions, such as Naya Bingi drumming ceremonies.
So when we gather and chant in the Congo. We're moving evil off of creation to bring forward righteousness, for we know righteousness have covered this earth as our water covered the sea.
It's like, why are you reaching heaven, man? That's not a big spirit. The God we are dealing with is a fire God, and the fire represents Jah. They say, three day and three nights straight, dance now being everyone happy. Yeah, but we always have a discipline inside that.
The whole overall family of Rasta, whether you use reggae, Bobo, 12 tribe, you know, or whatever organization you belong to, you start to realize we are one family, because all these organizations belong to one man, which is Emperor Haile Selassie I.
Man, Rastafari is a nice thing, I comfort your heart, man. It's a heartical conception, you know.
You know, Rasta is the way of life. Africa, it's not a religion.
Rastafari is something that, you know, you're born with. So I was born a Rastafari. African
woman. Once part of a decidedly male-dominated culture, Rastafari women have since begun to assert their presence and influence within the movement. African
woman. Being a Rastafari woman, a professional woman in this world, for me is just part of my everyday existence. It's my responsibility.
We are but human beings, male, female, complementary, dependent.
In Rastafari, we do not want our men to be behind us, in front of us. We are partners. We're next to.
We give thanks for the women, the empresses, and the sisters within the tribe of Rastafari, because they have strengthened the movement.
We have a concept of male superiority, female inferiority. Haile Selassie I denounced that.
In his own way, in no wise, set the woman below the man, but side by side.
Rastafari is a sacred way of life with its own distinctive practices. These practices, called liberty, are the ways in which Rastafari show devotion to the Creator through everyday expressions in appearance, dress, language, and diet.
And Rastafari is reminding the world that it's one, all races, and we are meant to be one with nature, to be ital. And so we look to eat the right foods.
Rastafari is our way of healthy living within the eating, within the ecological beliefs and foundations of Rasta, in terms of living in harmony with nature and with creation.
Our dreadlocks is our natural covering. If we're living to the laws of nature, naturality, the order of Rastafari, dreadlocks liberty.
Well, I'm very proud to keep my dreadlock today and keep these features. And I never yet think that is a wrong way. And especially when I know that if I was trying to save expense, it would be a easy way for me, because I don't have to go buy a razor every minute and clip.
Having a locks doesn't necessarily